was that? I don't think I saw deer at Sand Pond. Yeah. Yeah, it was. I think it was right up here in the cove up here. Yeah, I think that's where I saw him. Saw her. She was kind of over in the trees a little bit. Yeah. That passed right over us. It's gonna open up the clouds. That's deep. This is deep. Need to let more line out. Maybe just sit right there for a minute, right where that tree is. That might be a good spot right there. Maybe just sit right there, where you're at. That looks like a fresh break too. I'm not sure if this is Bullhead Bay here or. Yeah. Oh, you're in the tree now. Yep. Yeah, I'm not sure when that article was published though. I'm thinking right on the bottom still. Yeah, just let it sit there for a minute and that should It'd be a good spot there, I think. Now the worm does all the moving. No, not usually. Not unless the fish are really shallow. The fish are really shallow, they'll see your movement and then they'll scatter. On the bottom, man, oh geez. Wonder if it's a shiner. Leave my line over here and then I'll come over and help you take him off. I don't know what he is. It looks like a bluegill. Yep. Not really. Especially that size. Here with him here in a second. Yeah, so I can get him off right here. Let's see if I can get him while he's spinning. There we go. Right in here. I'm gonna try to get a picture of him right there. Yep. He said this wasn't part of the deal, this wasn't part of the plan. Should be able to get the hook right out of him. Got him? Good deal. Alright, let me rip right up here. Yeah, I think so, yeah. Pick him up. Oh, there he goes. Okay. I was gonna say, if they don't take off right away, you can sometimes pick them up and then blow into their mouth or blow on their face or whatever and give them the oxygen they need to get lively again. I got it. They'll usually just try to steal the worm and take off. They'll usually try it. Yep. Yeah. out to the edge of these weeds and drop line. And those little bluegill, they might hang out right in the weeds though. If you move your pole so the hook is right out the front, that should help a little bit. There you go, now you can kind of paddle a little bit easier. Yeah, I know, huh? Let's see what I can do right here. Run bottom. Shoot. I just lost my bait. Was that? Yep. I'm gonna come up and come around beside you again. Yeah, you're still shallow on your lure. I'm fishing quite a bit deeper. Get the stringer. Mm-hmm. Or barb. Or barb. Okay, you have that, players? I did? Are you sure? How do I put them in your, just let it loose, and then there you go. Go ahead and close it back up. And go ahead and lift them out of your kayak. With your... There you go. Get them, swing them. Make sure you don't have the pliers in there. Oh, here, if you want to take a picture, I can... He's got the hook good, so I'm not worried about him getting off. I'm gonna take a picture with my phone here. Oops. Sorry. Yo. No, not necessarily. No. The top of their fins here,
yeah.
That'll be sharp, and then these here fins off the sides are sharp too.
Now, or when it's bigger?
Now they are. You want to go and look for your, the pliers? Oh, actually, never mind, I got him. That's what you want to do anyway. Guess it'll take him here in a second. Let me get him secure first. Alright. You open up. No, I'll show you. I'm gonna secure him first so he doesn't get away. Oh, what kind of tangled mess is this? Yeah, I can paddle back up here in a second. I got a mess going on right now. Yeah, be good enough, bud. You sit there for a second. Yeah. He's secured in the boat. And then we can just tie them off. Put another. There we go. Okay. I'll come back up to you and show you how I secured him. He's in the weeds. Of course he is. I hate when they do that though. What's up? Oh, is it? Nice. Saved you a fish worm. Man, that's funny. Maybe I'll put a bobber on here too then. Got him? Okay, I'll show you what I did with this guy. Right through the gill, and then out the mouth with this end, and then through the hook or through the loop. What you? You're getting wet. Yep. Stay put there. I'll come over. Get turned here. Okay, we're good. Yep. He ate half of the one. Get out of my eye. Yes. He's a fly. I'm just gonna hook him once through here. Well, no. Out of here, and then you can put it in the same spot and catch a few more. Okay, you're good. Oh, here comes the boat. He's coming right down through. He's right here. Maybe let out a little bit more slack on the line there. What's that? Yeah. I'm gonna put a dough ball on again, I think, and then get my bobber hooked up here. There you go. Nice shot. Let some more out there. Oh, there you go. Reel. That one's a bigger one, actually. Maybe same size. Any saving the worm on that one? Well, I'll flop around in the bottom of the boat for a minute. I'll be right over. Okay. Now when I get the fish in the boat, I'll usually let out the slack once he's secured in the cockpit. Put a little slack in the line, so that way he can just kind of thrash around for a minute, get his energy out. I don't know where this guy is. He's Maybe I should have brought that 5 gallon bucket. Would you stop? You're tangling me up, bud. Yeah, I'm gonna come up alongside you here. And just hold still there for a second and I'll you guys come paddle back up into this tall grass here. Bit and then let out a little bit of slack. Okay, let me get you some slack here. I got the pliers, right? There we go. Finally. Open your mouth, it would help if you would hook it. I'll let you hold the hook and run pick up your bobber. And yeah, just go and thrash around for a minute. Here. Whoa, chill. So bad, chill. Okay, what I like to do is before I put another fish on, I'll get the previous fish in the boat. Because I've lost a few fish on a stringer before like that. And I go, ow! And I go, ow! Do you mind not doing that, please? Yeah, that's right. Okay, and then the next fish you put on, you don't have to go through the hook again. You just, you don't have to go through that little ring. What did you do? Alright, so you had to put him on the line. Just like that. This first one's gonna hold him on. Yeah. Yeah. Slime him. Uh oh. Look at the creation. And they'll try to sneak in and we got more motor than you, so they'll try to take your spot. I did try to make quick work of them. Put them on the water, but I'll kind of show you how to do it. That's, you can keep any number of bullhead, but it's the splake and trout, any size. Yep, only two bigger than 12. Wonder. Yeah, sorry. Yeah, we need to catch more fish. Where do they go with the pliers? That's kind of bugging. Okay, go ahead and put out some slack. And, put that over there. Oh, come on. I wonder if you could use half of a fish worm. Because that one you just caught is technically only half of a fish worm. Okay, you're good. Going real. Yeah, going real and then you're good. Okay. Well, I'm gonna try to find that pliers. And he said you gave it to me. Okay. Ow. It's fine. I don't know. I don't think they're in here. If they did end up under the seat somewhere. Oh, there's something under there. Oh, that's a bobber. Ouch. Need to find them so that way if we get a trouble hook, we can get it out. I suppose we could cut the line too and put a new hook on. We'll see what we're doing. Seems like you're catching them a little bit further down in the current, though. But yeah, I see fins on the surface. Let out more line. I see more fins. Give it a second. Wait for your bobber. There it goes. I'll set the hook. Yep, you got one on there. Yeah, I would think. Let me get him in your cockpit for a second, and I'm going to. He got away. Oh no! Really? I want to find that pliers. Pretty bad. Should I put it in my vest? Players isn't in there at all. Huh. I'll help you with that. Oh, it's right there. In your lap. I'm gonna go ahead and borrow your pole for a second. That's right. Yeah, see? Can you cast? I like to let line out. And then just hold onto it a little bit. And then put it right out there a little bit. And then just let it go for a minute. And then wait for it, and then once your bobber disappears for like a good couple, like they say, wait 3 seconds and then give it a little pop, the rod tip a little pop, and let the pole sit down a little bit is what I like to do. Maybe let the rod tip down a little bit more. There you go. And just let it sit there for a second. Reel it in just a bit. Might be over in this right there, it's good. Gotta sit there for a second. Yeah, I don't think they get real big, but yeah, there's probably some bigger ones. They're probably around. I'm gonna put this up there. Let's see if they like this. Ooh, it feels good. Okay. Felt good. Except on that rock. Yeah. Actually, not really cool, but sorry about that. This is my bait. Yeah. Is that? Yeah. Bait pole came off. Yeah, when your line catches like that, it snaps things pretty hard, and something like a bait ball will come off pretty easy. Stink bait. Get it back out there. Nice. Good deal. Going after it? Oh, gotcha. Let me step on all this fish. Yeah, he's like, hey, what the heck is going on with this thing? Oh my goodness. No. I got it. That was from the backlash. Had something going on with it. There you go. Give it a second. Yep. Got it. Now. Oh, too hard. Still got your worm though. When it goes underwater and then starts to swim away underwater. You got it. Got it. Got it. Got him. Nice. You got him that time. It's a lot about the patience with the blue with these things. Yeah, get them right over your cockpit right away. Get them in your cockpit. Let line up, and then he's secure. So, okay. Let me go get the let him thrash around in there for a minute. Thank you. these guys in your kayak too. You can hold this. Well, this hook is smaller. I'll usually set that down in there. Like two. Deal. Open the mouth. No, well, they do have little tiny teeth, but nothing like a bunny or anything like that. And then, we're gonna tie them off before we can do anything else. No, I'll take them up here. They're pretty slimy, yeah.
But it was saying they have pig squats on it, yeah.
Supposedly, I don't know. I'm not sure. Maybe someone licked them. A lot of bait balls. Yeah, I think so. On top of the water, feeding, and with the current conditions, bring out the bugs. So I think they're up on the surface, feeding on the bugs. And then they see something floating down the creek there or whatever. So they gotta go after that then. I think they're right there, right along those weeds, right where the current comes right around, and there goes, wait for it to go. Gotta outsmart them a little bit. Too hard. Almost had him. Oh, you got the. You got your. I'll trade it for a second. That's right. Yeah, let you hold that for a second. I'll take your pull. I'm gonna pull that in just a little bit. About where you had that last one there. You should be able to hook up again. I'll get a new worm put on this one for you. I fish all the time up in Missouri, so this is probably pretty exciting for you. You get to catch a bunch of fishies. We didn't bring that knife out, did we? With you? I might go ahead and start cutting up worms here in a minute. Not a problem, anytime. I'm just gonna set that on my kayak, I guess. I don't wanna slip with it in my pocket. There you go, good deal. That was a good shot right there, nice. Are you kidding me? Lost another bait bowl. Yes. I might just stick with worm. Yep. Good job. Nice. Oh, a little female, little sunfish. He's actually a little bit bigger. Yeah, you can. Where's my... Yeah. Let's see here. Bud, you... Sunfish all year. Guess what, bud? You're getting eaten. You get eaten. Yep. Yeah, he's gonna go on the stringer. We'll take him home with us. Yeah, their fins are sharp on the top there. He's in here so they don't get away. And usually, oh, there you go, perfect. Got a lot of thrash around here. They usually take year one or two. Try these guys on. There we go. Let's see if I can get one. Yep. What's that? No, you're good. You're good. I'm gonna chop this worm. Gave you a pretty good fat piece of the worm here. Let's wrap it up. Let's see here. That doesn't make a line. Here's one, so I'll be right this once. Well, see, if the longer they are, though, the easier they can pull them off the hook. The longer the worms are, the easier they can pull them off the hook. So, yeah, I usually try to do it at least once or twice. Fish got me all slimy. Yep, it must be. Yep. I was kind of thinking that there were other areas where there would be bullhead too, though. Sitting in the dead water too. So here in the weeds, it looks like. It doesn't lie into you. I'm kind of swimming a little bit. Okay, get all ready, bud. Oh, almost. Make sure you still get your worm on there. He's still on there. He's still on there. Yeah, go and reel it in. He's still on there. Yeah, he got it. I can see the thing swimming around. He's a tiny, tiny little thing, though. That one there, we might throw back. Oh, wait, no, he's not. What the heck? Yeah. Yep, unreel him in. Yeah, the cockpit. Oh, without line. It's a Bullhead, yep. I'm gonna take this guy over my kayak before he gets off. I'll bring the stringer over to you. This stringer to your kayak, I think. I might just hook this stringer to your kayak, I think. Where is he at? I heard him thrashing around everywhere. Yeah, he was not happy. Give me these here for a minute. If you swallow the hook. You still got your worm? Oh, he took it, didn't he? Those little sunfish, though. I don't know if there's anything right here either. Yeah, that's what I was thinking, too. Got one. Nice. Oh, mine's swimming. Mine started swimming. Well, I was chasing it for a second. There it goes. Get all ready. Being feisty. Is he being feisty? If you need some help, I can come up there or come down there. And a couple more places with the, I'll keep going to lift up the rod tip, with fish in them. Right here by the front of your kayak. I don't like leaving bobbers late because that's a sign that you've been there and probably catching fish there and stuff. And other people will see that and it's a giveaway. That's a lot of paddle boarders. Alright. That? Yeah. Yeah, you should be good now. I'm gonna try this little hole right back here and see if there's anything in this little hole. And then, you know, see if I can find some more places for when we go pick up Sean. And I'm usually very cautious of other kayakers and boaters. They you let someone know your secret spots and stuff, or where you've been catching fish, and it's game over for your fishing spot. I don't know if there's anything in this hole. I think they're just probably more worried about having fun at camp. Pretty sure those kids are just more worried about having fun at camp than anything else. I'm gonna go up here just a little bit further again. I can come back down if you need any help again or anything. I'll stay pretty close. I'm gonna go back up here again. Oh, got another one. Nice. Yeah, I'll have to look those up when we get back and find out just exactly what they are. Get him. All right. Through here. Yeah, there's a few bugs out here. I post Sean right up where you were. Over here on this other side. Yeah, I can put them in my kayak in a second. I don't have a baggie with me, do I? Yeah, I can go ahead and put those in my kayak here. I'm just gonna get carried right out. I don't put them in a bag, but